Well, hello there, I'm Green Dean. I thought the season was over, but welcome back to video number 56. I was out walking today and I saw some crowfoot grass, and I thought that is something I need to do a video on. So, video 56, brought some home for a demonstration, crowfoot grass. Let's go do it.
Before we head out in the field, let's take a look at a couple of things about the crowfoot grass to help us identify it. Now, if it were discovered today in name, we might even call it the helicopter grass. And here is why, because you get a little later, but the two points I want you to notice is all the digits, or that they're called, of this particular grass, come out from one central point. This one happens to have 1, 2, 3, 4, it has 6 blades. Just like a helicopter, blades come out from one central point. See, that's one point. The other is, if I tip the grass, you can see they're all on one plane here. There isn't a blade coming out from down here, or another one, or over here. There's not a branch down here, or a branch down here. All the digits are coming from one particular spot. They're located in the center, and they come out from here. So I want you to think of like a helicopter blade, because that is the best to make sure you've got the right plant. And none of these are more than about an inch and a half long at the most. So you've got anywhere from 2 to 7, usually 5 to 5 or 6 digits, all radiating from one central point, and all on the same plane. And that's rather important, because you know grasses can be maddeningly, here's one with 5, maddeningly difficult to identify. So anything you can do to make sure you have the right grass when you have it is it, and this is it. Crowfoot grass, or just call it the helicopter grass. Here's a great little stand of crowfoot grass. Notice how it's growing in a very low, crawling type of manner. And it's pretty easy to identify. Look at this. See that? This one has 5 little digits coming out from one central point. Now they can have as many as 7 and as few as 2. This is probably has more than 7. This looks like a twin. But usually it's 2 to 7. Average is about 5. And they're all coming, as I said, coming up from one particular spot, right there. Right there, yeah. The thing I like about crowfoot grass is it's pretty hard to misidentify. And how do you tell when to pick it? Well, see, here's a green one. The green one doesn't want to let go. Whereas this brown one, if I give it a tug, comes off quite easily. And that's how you simply collect them. You simply reach down and put your hand under them and give them a little pull. They come off, and you've got them. And I'll show you how to win with them in a moment. One thing we also have to do is make sure there's no purple fungus on any of these plants. Make sure they're nice green or brown. You don't want any purple fungus, which can make you ill. And that happens with all grasses. The other thing is, don't be too concerned about taking some of these, because each little seed head can produce about 60,000 seeds. So Mother Nature's not being stinted too much by if you just take a couple hundred thousand.
Got some butter on it, you know? Very much like buckwheat. Delicious. From the trail to the tummy. Can't beat that. Need some jelly. Pyroganthus jelly. See, it all works.
In case you're wondering, in that recipe, I mixed equal parts of ground up crowfoot seed with flour. That's how I get a good balance. And it's very delicious. Tastes like buckwheat, very close to buckwheat. If you grind it up, you get rid of the texture issues because the seed is so small, it actually kind of has the texture of sand. It's an edible sand and it's a tasty sand, but you know, for some people, texture is a very significant issue, so grinding up gets rid of that problem. Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize. Let's itemize the crowfoot grass. Identification, well, that's fairly easy. You know, it grows in mats. It tends to be about 2 feet long, but it only comes up to about a foot high when it wants to point upward. But of course, the big thing is you're going to have 2 to 7 digits on top. And they're usually it's 5 to 5 or 6. And they're all going to be from one point, and they're all going to be on the same plane. So think of a helicopter. Remember, all those blades in the helicopter are all on the same point. The little digits are about 1 inch long, and the seeds hang down, kind of like either a comb or a brush. Time of year, that's fairly easy. Fall. And when you go to pick it, you reach your hand underneath the end of the grass head and you pull it. And if it lets go easily, that's the one you want. If it fights you, let it be. Environment. Well, you know, they like all kinds of environments. They go from heavy, wet soil to sandy, dry soil. You can find them from the swamp to the beach, which is very convenient, actually. Let me stop and think about it. Method of preparation. Well, you can eat it raw as a trailside nibble. Just winnow it out in your hand. Get those little golden seeds in your hand and just eat them as they are. But they do have the texture of sand. Remember that. They don't taste like sand, and you can chew them up easily enough, but they do have that texture. Or you can cook them as they are, put them in a little fat and cook them, roast them. Or the way to get rid of the entire texture is simply to grind them into a flour. And it's delicious. As I said before, it has a very nice buckwheat nuance to it. And when I mix it with regular flour, half and half, it just bakes beautiful. Crowfoot grass is easy to identify, easy to collect, easy to winnow, easy to prepare, and easy to eat. And it's easy on the tummy, so it's good all around. I enjoy it. Thank you for joining me here in my 56th video here on eattheweeds.com. If you want to learn more about crowfoot grass, go to Eat the Weeds and read about it, and about 160 other edible plants as well. So until next time, this is Green Dean. I want to have you think green, want you to eat green, and that includes occasionally some crowfoot grass. Toodles.